Sounds like
Hello.
back to natural calamity.
Today we're going to be talking about why psychological horror sucks.
And why new age horror sucks.
Yeah. And we are not adding any ads, but we're talking about Bird Box here.
We're also talking about that one where you cannot hear it, or where you can, oh, where it cannot hear you, you cannot make a sound. What does that mean?
The quiet one. A
A
quiet place.
quiet place. Oh God, that
Yeah.
was so bad.
That
And
was so bad.
the Jake Gyllenhaal one, the one that was in Netflix special, what was it? Velvet Buzzsaw. It's a painting.
I'm the
Velvet
pretty
Buzzsaw.
thing that lives in the house.
Oh, that was terrible. No, that was terrible.
That was so slow. That was so
Yeah,
boring.
okay, now I thought it was leading somewhere. Maybe it's a
Yeah.
metaphor, but
Yeah.
art films need to stop. Art filmmakers need to rethink their lives. Everyone who thinks they're Charlie Kaufman, they are not Charlie Kaufman. They need to
Yeah.
reevaluate and realize that they are just plain bad. And just not having a plot is not the same as making an art film. You're just bad at having a plot.
Yeah. The plot is this is a mentally ill person, or the plot is, oh, this person has a disability.
Yeah, psychological horror has boiled down to psychopaths. They think that the only thing that can be psychological horror is a psychopath. Do they know what a psychopath is? No, they don't. They think that someone who kills other people is a psychopath.
That's untrue because we can kill other people, but we are not psychopaths.
Psychopath can be someone who doesn't kill people, and someone who kills people can be someone who's not a psychopath, which
Yeah.
usually is someone who's not a psychopath.
Yes. There's a Venn diagram. And that Venn diagram was people who kill, people who are psychopaths, and there's a very small area that intersects.
Little more intellectual, then they're like, oh, not psychopath, sociopath, because they think it's like an intellectual version of psychopath.
Yeah.
It's not what a sociopath is.
Yeah.
You couldn't manipulate one person if you worked on your script for 5 months. You are not a sociopath.
Listen, if you watch Split and you
I
watch
have
their
not.
trailer of dissociative identity disorder, first of all, they call it MPD, which is no longer accepted in DSM. So this movie, it comes out and they're like, oh, we're going to show you a personality disorder. And the kind of stigma that it propagates. It shows that man as somebody who's inherently really violent. So he has this
Okay.
alter called Patricia, who is like this violent lady who kills people.
Okay.
And the
Right.
way,
So
right, you know
many
what
people
I'm
like
talking
the new J.K. Rowling book as well, right?
about.
It is extremely transphobic.
Disgusting. Cancel her right now.
Yeah, if you haven't already.
She also uses that, right? That one of the alters is trans, and the trans alter
No.
kills
Oh no,
people.
it's not alters. It's just that he dresses up as a woman to kill. It's not even a DID thing.
Don't understand why people still follow her or buy her books. Just stop now.
Don't know. This is the next book she's releasing. I don't know who's buying it. I don't know if it should be released. I don't
It
know
shouldn't.
who is thinking of releasing it, okay? Which publishing
Right.
house wants to be blacklisted that way? One representation of a sociopath that I think was really spot on and good was Grant Ward in Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Like,
Yeah.
that is actually really well done, and it's a complex story about how he reaches that point in the first place. And there are behaviors, like obviously the pyromaniac as a kid, and then how it shapes up, and that the thing that sociopaths tend to have, that one belief based on which they commit all their crimes. If they're into crime.
Same with Angelina Jolie's character in Girl Interrupted. That was a really good portrayal of a sociopath. And usually you do not see women casted as sociopaths. So that was great.
Right. Another good psychological thriller is Shutter Island. Have you watched
Oh,
that?
yeah. I haven't yet.
It starts to play out as this investigation. A murder investigation of sorts into Shutter Island. There's a little asylum there. Not a little asylum, it's actually a very big asylum. It's scary how big that asylum is.
It's kind of like Penhurst.
Like what?
This now haunted asylum in America. It's huge. Like, it goes over hills and trees.
Can I give you spoilers?
No. I mean, yeah, I've never minded spoilers. Go ahead.
Leonardo DiCaprio is there and he's investigating into this missing person from the asylum. And he's looking into the records and there seems to be like some person who is supposed to be in a cell, but he cannot actually find that person anywhere. And it seems that the people at the asylum who run the asylum have some very shady business going on. Which they usually do, don't they?
They do. They're not taking any names, but yeah, go ahead. Shady business?
The shady business going on. There's like this lighthouse, which is abandoned there, okay?
Of course.
And it seems that it doubles as an operation theater where the main doctor who runs the asylum does lobotomies.
Of course.
Complicated plot, and he is finally able to unravel it to a point. And he goes into the lighthouse and he reaches the top and he finds the doctor there, except there is nothing there except one desk. Okay, and the doctor is just sitting there. That's it. And then he realizes that the person whom he had been chasing, the person who was missing from the asylum, is he himself. He's not an investigating officer. Now see, that was a good thing because you thought that it would be, you know, a psychological thriller about what is going on in an asylum and how those people's psychology plays into it. But then it's about the investigating officer all along. That is really good.
Yeah, that sounds great. Now I need to watch it and I need to watch it tonight. One like psychological horror like TV show that I really liked was Sharp Objects. I hated the book. The book was bordering on pedophilia. But the TV series was really, really well made. Like, I think that's... it's about... Okay, spoiler alert.
I'm not going to watch it.
It's really good. So, like, spoiler alert for anyone who really wants to watch it. It's about this investigative reporter. Mm-hmm. And she's being sent back to her native town. It's a very small town called Bingap. To investigate two girls who went missing. And she goes back and she realizes, like, all the town politics that are involved in these two little girls. And everything about them and her mother. So she has a very complicated relationship with her mother. Yeah. And the entire time, her mother has such a scary vibe. Like, it's not even horror. It's just like her mother gives you the creeps. You imagine being that person's daughter and you're like, I am out. So there's a huge, huge trigger warning for Salfan, the main character Salfan.
Obviously, we need to talk about Insidious 2.
Yes.
What was his name? Parker.
Peter Parker. Parker Crane. Parker Crane. Yeah.
The black
veiled bride. I don't even name it. I am scared. Okay. Insidious is one movie that I don't.
Let me just wear this for the next section while we discuss
the black veiled bride.
Yes.
This is kind of what the material of her wedding dress was.
Yeah, it was scary.
Yeah.
So, obviously, there, it is more a matter of dysphoria, right? Except a different kind of dysphoria. Because what his mother forced him to act like a girl because she wanted a girl.
That scene where he makes her that picture... And then he signs his actual name.
And then he's like, that's not your name.
And then the mother slaps him. Oh, yes. Jesus.
Yeah. And then after all that, he has associated his youth with being a girl. And so he grows old and then he becomes nostalgic about his childhood. So he's like, oh, I will dress up as a girl and I will kill people. Because I miss being a child.
That's the thing that traditional horror movies. Horror movies that actually rely on horror.
On a plot. Okay, that's my biggest problem with new age horror films. There is no background. There is no lore. There is no reason that these monsters exist and are hunting people down. You just accept that they are. It's like suspension of disbelief का एक हद होती है, वो हद इन लोगों ने पार कर दिया है.
Right, like world building is a complex thing to do, and if you can't do it,
just don't make a film. We're qualified because we're not making films. We know we cannot, so we aren't doing it.
Yeah, we understand our limitations. But James Wan, if you want to sign us up, we have some stories.
We have some good stories. We have lore to back it up. Yeah.
Killing of a Sacred Deer. Have you seen it?
Oh, I have heard of it. I think you told me not to watch it. And then you immediately called me as whatever the opposite of a recommendation is.
Opposition. So I started watching it. Okay. And it had a lot of long, awkward silences.
I don't get it. Same with like the pretty thing that lives in the house. It was just black mold. Why are you so worked up about black mold?
Anyway, so that movie, long awkward silences, right? And then their children fall sick, and that's supposed to be the horror. Like, I'm sure the American health system is horrific, but it doesn't warrant a whole horror movie.
Really, horror was capitalism all along.
They catch a disease, which is like a zombie disease, and then they fall sick, and then they have to stay in the hospital, and then they all die.
Zombie films are not...
horror. They're funny.
Like, funny horror needs to stop being classified as horror in the first place. It's comedy. Yes, it's not comedy. It's comedy. Horror. It's not horror comedy.
No. There is nothing like a horror comedy. That's an oxymoron.
Which tried to be horror and turned out a comedy.
Yeah. Like, I love the Scream movies, but those are not horror.
Which movie?
Scream.
Okay, I have not watched that. Are you talking about Scary Movie?
Scary Movies, right, not Scream. Scream is the character.
Yeah.
Yeah, Scary Movies. They were not scary. They lied. It's called a clickbait.
Stop lying to me and telling me that sci-fi is horror. If I'm asking for horror, I want supernatural things. Okay, I want ghosts.
Demons.
I want people going to their psychiatrist and being told they are crazy.
Yeah,
because there is a ghost in their house.
Didn't we just say we don't want that? Didn't we like just say that we don't want mental illness in horror movies?
Yeah, but it's not mental illness, right? Because the ghost is real. The ghost is real. The mental illness is false. Why did you bring us into a house where four murders have happened?
Yeah, I love how white people are just like, oh, so this was a place where like five ritualistic killings took place, and this is native land where we killed native people, and this is our dream house.
Yeah, and then the white says, hey, I think there's some ghost in the attic or something. He's like, ghost in the attic in this house where five murders happened? I think not.
That's good horror. Like, Amityville is good horror.
Amityville is great horror.
It has psychological factors. It has supernatural. It's chef's kiss.
It has lore. It has a good background. More than a ghost, it's like the whole haunted house thing, right? It's not a ghost. It's not a demon. It's like somewhere in between.
Yeah, it's like this house is the problem.
That the house has become a demon. It's feeding on your insecurities.
Yeah.
It's making you want to kill the people. And the Winchester house, right?
Oh yeah, the Winchester Mansion.
That's actually what Sam and Dean Winchester are named after.
The Winchester House, the whole story behind it is also really interesting. Same with the Lizzie Borden House. Have you heard the whole story about Lizzie Borden? Yeah, that house is
that
really interesting to me.
Supernatural ones. So, talking about good horror films.
Conjuring. Loved it.
There is lore, there is background, there is romance.
There's romance. There is one kiss and there's one song on the guitar. There is romance.
Conjuring 2 is a rom-com. It classifies because there is one couple and there is Elvis Presley's song, Can't Help Falling in Love, and they do one dance. It's a rom-com. It classifies as a comedy because it has a happy ending.
Nicholas Sparks needs to learn something.
My main problem with Insidious is how fucking dramatic.
And even like when their title comes on and there's like that really loud music,
Yeah.
that's the biggest jump scare in that
And
entire movie.
Elise, the old woman.
Yeah.
Elise. She's so dramatic about everything. So creepy. She's a real horror.
Yeah, she's not the one who's fighting the ghost. She is the ghost. Second one is actually my
Better.
Favorite one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Really like it. Really like when like the husband goes absolutely batshit. I really like that. The main character, right?
No,
he gets possessed by Parker Crane.
Named Patrick Wilson.
Yeah, Wilson. No, that's the actor's name.
Yeah, that's the actor's name.
What's the character's name? I don't remember.
His name is... okay, so there's the child, Dalton, who is also
Dalton.
In Iron Man 3. And there is the father. Yeah, I thought I would be able to draw a connection, but I cannot. Where he's holding something behind his back. He's like, hey, what are you holding behind your back? I forgot his name.
Yeah. And then he's like, why don't you ask
him? Like, oh, what is Parker Crane holding behind his back? And then there's the dramatic mysterious music.
Yeah. And then he's like, a knife.
And let me see what you have.
A knife.
No!
Oh, I'm going to attack you and take you by surprise. Like, oh, first prove to me that you're a psychic.
Yeah. We haven't talked about a favorite horror movie yet. We didn't talk about Oculus.
Oculus.
It checks all the boxes. It's psychological. It talks about delusions. It's supernatural.
It's the right kind of jump scare. You cannot really escape that situation if you were in it.
Because
she has all those precautions in place and it just does not work out.
The entire thing about how the precautions is what kills her.
Yeah. She goes to great lengths to avoid. And then that is what kills her.
Yeah.
And then the boy not being taken seriously.
Yeah.
He is accounting for like 2 murders now.
Yeah.
And both times it was this supernatural entity that is just after him.
And you can't prove it because the camera shows something else and what's happening is different. It's just, it's scary on so many levels. Same with Sinister. I can't watch that movie again. It's just too scary.
The implications of it that, okay, this God is going to come after you if you have seen him on a film. And you are watching a film about the God. So technically you have seen him on the film. So is he going to come for you next?
Yeah, so and like all parts of Sinister, it's not just like the first part is scary.
Yeah,
all parts of Sinister are equally terrifying.
Talking of underrated horror films, Devil. People who have not watched Devil, it's not called The Devil or anything. It's just called Devil. The plot is that there are 5 people who get locked inside together inside an elevator. Except one of those people amongst them is the devil himself. They cannot figure out who, but one by one, they keep dying. And they have to figure out who is the devil and how to defeat him.
I was scared to go in my lift. And I live on the 11th floor. And I was like, it's fine. I'll just take the stairs. It's okay.
Very good film. They have like good lore. They have a backstory. Like each character gets their own backstory for why they would be in that position.
In that lift at that particular time.
Yeah,
it's a very, very well written movie.
Yeah, and what sins they are paying for over there. And it all connects like this, people outside trying to get inside and their stories connect with the people who are inside.
Yeah.
It's really nice.
It is.
They have something called a plot, which the makers of Bird Box maybe should look up. Ouija.
Yeah, really good. That is like 2000s horror.
Okay,
that's
so that was
good
so
2000 horror.
That was so scary that Anami and I had both watched it before separately. And we had repressed the memory so deep that we did not realize we watched this film before till we reached the last scene.
And also that movie we watched that night, Demon.
Oh, yes, I remember.
Demon.
Demonic.
Demonic, not Demon.
Also
Demonic. Yeah. James Wan has done some really good stuff. But he's also... Really,
bad stuff like Annabelle Comes Home.
Annabelle Comes Home could have
a disgrace to the Conjuring universe.
Yes, it could have done so much better. There was a scary bride, and they didn't look into her. Even with that movie that was before Annabelle Comes Home, I forgot the title. I didn't like that either. Yeah, I didn't like that either. Just
I
something
like
about it was not scary. I like the Annabelle movie, the first one.
Yeah.
That is so scary. That scene where the baby is on the ground and books are falling around. That scene is a masterpiece.
I don't understand why they couldn't show us the Ed and Lorraine to actually go there and intervene and bring Annabelle back. Why did you not get that soon?
Yeah.
That would have been so much more fun.
More of the road trip that they were on and the whole symmetry thing. More of that and of less that. Of whatever they did would
was
have
that
been
Annabelle. Was it an Annabelle creation or was it an Annabelle where they show that scene where Ed and Lorraine are asking these two girls what was happening?
That was in Conjuring.
In conclusion, psychological thrillers are bad.
New age horror is the worst.
Is the worst. If you're making a horror film, it needs to have a plot.
I mean, if you're not making a film, it needs to have a plot.
Not having a plot is not the same as making an art film. If you think you're Charlie Kaufman, you are not.
We'll make a plot.
Charlie Kaufman, who is watching this video for some reason. Charlie, you are still Charlie. Let's not try to Charlie Kaufman.
He's not watching this video. He's not. It's okay.
He has better things to do.
Yeah. Please make more horror movies with actual demons and ghosts. But don't make it like Annabelle Comes Home.
Annabelle Comes Home was terrible. Potential of a good horror film.
Yes. Add demon. Add possession.
Yeah.
Add
there
ghost.
There needs to be a story. There needs to be a reason that the ghost or demon or whatever is doing what it is doing. There needs to be a motive.
Yes.
And there needs to be a reason that those people are scared. And there needs to be a reason that they're dying even after trying everything.
Yes. If you're making a horror movie, watch Oculus first.
Yes.
That's the conclusion for the video. And with that, we'll see you guys next week on